Traditionally, FSIS inspection program personnel, IPP, often use tempering to collect product samples. However, the drill and drill bit are typically used in frozen egg products to sample the product for microbiological analysis. The drill sampling method can now be used for frozen non-intact meat and poultry products to sample for microbiological or even residue analysis. This video will explain how this sampling method is accomplished and show why the drilling method may be preferable to product tempering for certain meat and poultry products. The main difference between other sampling methods and the drill sampling method is the use of a drill bit, and a spoon to collect the samples. This method is best used on frozen, non-intact product, so as to maximize the amount of product shavings in the sample and minimize the amount of ice. In addition, it's best used on reasonably homogeneous product so as to avoid having a disproportionate sampling of only part of a product, such as too much skin or bone. It's important to remember that the equipment must be appropriate for the purpose, and in this case, the purpose is to secure shavings from frozen product. Consequently, the drill must be capable of drilling into the frozen product at an appropriate speed. The drill bit must also be able to produce large enough shavings that can be collected and placed in a sample bag. The drill should be a variable speed, heavy-duty electric drill capable of drilling into frozen product. The drill bit should be 11/16 inch or larger, with no less than a 12-inch shank, then twist type. The drill bit should be one typically used for wood. It should not be a metal drill bit. Since it's best to drill within 1 inch of the bottom of the frozen block of product, and you want to make sure that neither the product nor the shavings touch the drill, follow these guidelines. A 12-inch bit is only acceptable for blocks that are approximately 6 inches thick. An 18-inch bit is preferred for blocks that are approximately 9 inches thick, and a 24-inch or longer bit should be used for blocks that are 12 inches thick or more. If only one drill bit is used to sample various thicknesses of product, then the drill bit should be long enough to accommodate the thickest product that is to be sampled. For the drill sampling method, sampling should be done in a sanitary environment using clean and sanitized or sterile equipment. Make sure the drill is clear of any potentially loose foreign material before it's used. It should be cleaned before and after each use. However, do not try to sanitize the drill. The drill bit, however, must be cleaned and sanitized before and after each use. Once the product is exposed for sampling, first remove any frost and ice crystals from the top of the block of product before beginning the drilling process. Be sure to shake any loose sanitizer off the drill bit before beginning to drill. Drill at approximately a 45-degree angle to within 1 inch of the bottom of the product container, if possible, but not more than the drill bit safely permits. Try to avoid drilling through any hump on top of the block of product, which may have been caused by the freezing process. Collect the shavings with a sterile spoon and fill the Whirlpack bags to the fill line. A spatula is provided in the sampling kit to assist in getting the shavings onto the spoon. It will take more than one drilling and collection to fill the 2 Whirlpack bags that are required for microbiological analysis. Also, be sure to keep the sampled shavings secure and frozen until it's time to package them for shipment to the designated laboratory. Follow the normal procedures for shipping samples to the laboratory. This video demonstrates packing the samples when 1 gel pack is provided by the laboratory. Use the number of gel packs that are provided by the laboratory. This process, including all 3 methods of shipping the samples, can be reviewed in the FSIS notice, Imported Raw Pork Products Sampled for Salmonella Analysis, Attachments 4 and 5. By viewing this video and reviewing the FSIS notice, you should be able to effectively sample frozen, non-intact meat and poultry products and avoid the long process of tempering product unnecessarily. Thanks for watching.